We've introduced the notion of an induced matrix norm. And the idea was that the matrix norm measured by how much a vector gets stretched. And then we can just use different vector norms to measure the stretching. So, the matrix 2 norm is the case where to measure the input vector, we use the 2 norm. To measure the output vector, we use the 2 norm. And that's all there is to it. Now, this turns out to be a really nice norm for theoretical purposes. It allows us to analyze various things. The problem with the norm is that it's hard to compute. And to give you an idea of how hard to compute it is, later in the course you're going to find out that if the matrix is Hermitian, symmetric, then the 2 norm is equal to the magnitude of the largest eigenvalue, largest in magnitude. Now, remember how hard it is to compute the eigenvalue of a typical 2x2 matrix. It's not easy. You need to find the root of the characteristic polynomial. Finding roots of polynomials is non-trivial. It gets harder when you try to do it for a 3x3 matrix. The polynomial ends up being of degree 3. Degree n for an n by n matrix. So, the bottom line is, for certain matrices, we're going to see that it's relatively easy to compute the 2 norm. But in general, it's very difficult, and therefore it is a norm, a matrix norm, that we use for theoretical purposes rather than to actually use in practice when we're trying to measure the norm of a matrix.